Everyone, hi, I'm Bernardo Zamora. I worked in the Microsoft store. I work in the Dev Center team, which is the team that helps get your games into the store. So we'll talk a little bit more about what is this Microsoft store that our friends from Astroneer, Brendan, talked about before. We'll talk about some of the capabilities that the store has to enable your games to make money and reach more customers. And finally, we'll talk about some of the self-publishing capabilities that we have in the store. So just to start, when we're talking about the Microsoft Store, it's the place where your games can be submitted and target Windows 10 PCs, Xbox One devices, and mixed reality devices. So I was in one of the business reviews we have every quarter a few months ago, and I was hearing some quotes from some of the top game publishers in the world in the store. They were saying, for example, in console, they had the best quarter ever. On PC, surprisingly for most of us, they're seeing a lot of resurgence and growth again on PC. So you see that getting your games in this single place allows you to do both. But not only that, we're able to get a lot of opportunity in the mixed reality area. And just to get a sense a little bit about what the capability and the reach for the store is, here's some just sample numbers. More than 600 million people are using devices that have Windows 10 where your game can run. Xbox One outsold PS4 this last December. And if you produce a game for console, 700 million hours played. So gamers out there spend a lot of time playing your games and other games, of course. And just since the launch of Xbox One X, there's been more than 220 exclusive games and more than 1,300 titles also launched for that platform. You probably realized a few months ago, PUBG launched in December, PlayerUnknown Battlegrounds. In this last couple of months only, there have been more than 5 million players. So if you produce a good game, you will get players for that one. And another example is Minecraft. There's been more than 144 million copies sold of Minecraft up to date, up until January of this year. So if you build a good game, there's an audience there. And examples of games that have launched so far, you see Gears of War, Forza Horizons, Halo Wars, Zoo Tycoon, Record, and many, many, many others, indies, for example, that have made the console and PC their platform for launch. So we've seen many of these games being very successful. And we're also seeing a new trend now. The new trend is mixed reality. There's a whole section in the store that has mixed reality apps and games. And something I found out last week from our marketing friends, we started with 30 apps or games when mixed reality launched. There are now more than 130. And curiously, 3 out of the top 25 apps or games in the store today are mixed reality ones. So again, submitting to one single place, you can target Xbox, you can target PC, and you can start exploring this mixed reality opportunity. And let me play a video, minute and a half, just tells you some examples of what are some of these new games coming with mixed reality concepts.
Thank you.
that's mixed reality. That's the mixed reality opportunity. And as you think about bringing your games to the console, to the PC, or mixed reality, or all three, think about what the store provides you to be able to monetize your games, to promote your games. So as I mentioned, you can build ones, target different platforms, so it reduces the cost and complexity to get your game to market. The store supports pre-beta, pre-order, full release. It supports all the different combinations to get your game from idea into full release. It supports both physical and digital. Most of the games are now digital, but we have still several games minting their disc and sending the discs, especially in countries, for example, where the bandwidth is not as high. Discs are still a premium way of getting your game out there. Also, for digital, and Brendan from Astron Eater mentioned in the previous session, we have IARC. We have an agreement with IARC to be able to certify your games with different age ratings for all the world. So it not only saves you weeks and weeks of work, but it also saves you a lot of money. It's all integrated into the store. You can release a game, or you can add add-ons. You can have bundles, you can have consumables, you can have subscriptions. Pretty much every one of the monetization options out there, it's supported in the store. You can have digital downloads, you have map packs, you can have all of those already supported. You can have a games, but you also have mixed reality apps also, all of them supported. You can have full GA for every single user across all the platform, or you can support flights, where you target different binaries to different users and also get analytics for these different segments. Every time you do a release, you can figure out what works and what doesn't work in real time. Because also the store supports real-time analytics. As Brendan mentioned before, we support crashes, we support analytics, but in the last few months we've added real time. So minutes after you start launching a new version, you get data about acquisitions, data about crashes, which also is one of the major features that developers are using to be able to release more rapidly. And another example of the multiple things you can do is you can respond to reviews. In Xbox, that's very new. PC, we've had it for a while. Somebody posts a review saying something works or something doesn't work, you can respond immediately, and you can start the dialogue with that user, either to debug something or to explain how to solve some problem that the user has. So all of those are capabilities that the store has today. And what do you need to do to be able to get your game to start using all of these capabilities? You need to get an account in Dev Center. Dev Center is the portal where you do all of these configurations, do all the analytics, then create your submission. You put your binary, age rating, pricing, markets. You define if it's a beta, if it's going to be a release. You configure all of those properties. You configure the descriptions. You target which devices. You might want to start with Xbox. You can do PC later and then mixed reality later. Then you release it. You submit it, and it goes through certification. It validates that everything works. So last minute surprises don't catch you. Say, oh, I didn't know this set of hardware didn't work. We try to catch that as much as possible for you. You can actually do pre-releases. You can distribute tokens for reviewers, for example. You can do pre-orders, and then you release it. And then once it's out there, we have the tools to help you optimize it. Not only can you do analytics real time, you can do health, crashes, reviews, but also you can do some A/B testing of the content inside the game. You can see by country, health, crashes, by devices, if some devices are having more problems than others, for example. And then you can continue expanding the game. Astron Eater, as we heard, it has been live for many, many, many months, and they keep on adding DLCs and content packs and new features. So the store allows you to do that. Again, you can use flighting to do it and catch issues before you distribute to all the community. Or you can go wide to the 100% of your users on day one. And then you can do sales. The store does a lot of good promotion for your sales. Then you can add trailers, you can add 4K assets. You can continue to grow the game and evolve it, because once the game catches a good community, you want to keep on building in that community. And how does this portal look like? This portal, what we call Dev Center, is completely self-service. You go in and this is exactly how it looks. You choose your game and then you go into the different screens and you configure anything in the game. From pricing to descriptions to age ratings to the sales, all of that is self-service online. You do your own submissions, they go live. And this year, what we're trying to do is make this process more agile and faster. So if you work with Dev Center before, you'll see faster times to turn around, faster certification, faster time to go live. So that's some of the high-level capabilities that you can do in Dev Center today. So as you're thinking of expanding your reach to your game, think about the Microsoft Store, place where you can target console, Windows 10 PCs, and mixed reality. More than 600 million users are accessible to you for both apps and games. And we have a very advanced self-services publishing system. So you can use it from the simplest game to one of the most complex games that you saw there, like Halo Wars, Gears of Wars, or the one that was released yesterday, Sea of Thieves. So all of those are using the system that we see today to target all these platforms. So this is at a high level what the store can do for you, and I'm open for any questions you might have. Yes? My question is, what is my favorite game? It keeps evolving. Because I knew I was going to co-present with Astroneer, I've been playing Astroneer the last 2 weeks. So it just keeps on changing. After I finish it, move to the next. Cuphead was one of the best ones. I tried it until I get very frustrated. It just gets super complicated a few levels. So it just keeps on evolving. And I was a fan for Gears of War for about 6 months. So it just keeps changing. And I actually just bought Pac-Man, an Xbox for my daughter. I keep on playing games. Hopefully, I'm ready to start playing Sea of Thieves now. I just downloaded it, but I'm a GDCO, I cannot play that one. Thank you very much. Bernardo Zamora, ask me any questions after this session.